What's up guys, welcome to the channel, and in this episode we'll be looking at how to set up a virtual machine with Microsoft Azure. So the account will be free and I will be looking at the steps of setting this up. So let's get started. So first, go to your browser, search for Microsoft Azure, go to the first link you find. After that, create a free account. You'll have to enter your Microsoft account. If you don't have one, then just create one. Once you've entered your email, you'll have to fill in some more details, verify your number, etc. Once you're done with that, the next step, you'll have to fill in your credit card details. Once you're done, just sign up. Once you're done creating an account and you've signed in, you should see a dashboard like this. So we're halfway there, just a couple more steps. So the next thing that we're looking for is this free services. If you can't find yours, then just search for it in the search bar. Free services. Once you're here, look for this Windows virtual machine. We also have a Linux version, but today I'll be covering the Windows version. Click on create. And once we're here, we're now in the steps of creating the virtual machine. The first thing that we do is create a new resource group. We'll call it resource group 1. For the name, we'll just call it virtual machine 1. The region, you're supposed to pick the region that is closest to your broker or closest to you. In my case, I'll pick Western Europe. For the image, here we have four options in the free tier. So which one should you go for? Let me just show you something interesting. Once we start clicking on this, you'll notice that the free service starts to appear. Same for this, free service eligible. Same goes for this. So the only one that doesn't have this label is this one. So for that sake, let's leave this one alone. The server core, let's also skip that one. So you can either pick this one or this one. We'll go with this one. So the next thing that we're supposed to look at is the size. Click on see all sizes, and here it is, B1S, and it also has a label of free services, so click on that. Next is the username and the password that you want for your RDP. So in my case, I'll just call it VM1. Leave this as they are, RDP, leave the rest unchecked. Click on review and create. And create. So this deployment process will take a couple of minutes. I'll just speed up this part of the video. So now the deployment is complete, the virtual machine is ready. The next step is just connecting to the RDP. So let's go to the resources. And once you're here, click on connect RDP. And click on download RDP file. Show all. So before you go to this step, go to your settings. And make sure this setting is enabled here. So once you've enabled it, click on the file that you've just downloaded, connect, fill in the credentials that you filled in earlier. And there you go. So once you get here, there are two ways that you can get your trading platform on the virtual machine. So the first one is to open the Internet Explorer, search for your trading, search for your broker, download your trading platform, and install it on the virtual machine. So that is the first way. But on this virtual machine, I found that it's a very slow process. So the alternative, which is faster, is to go on your local PC, download your trading platform from there. In my case, I'll use MetaTrader 5. I'll download it for Windows. As it's downloading, I'll create a new folder on my desktop. And this is where now I want to install this trading platform. So here it is. So now in our installation, we're going to go to settings, browse, and the installation folder that we're going to choose is the folder that we've just created. And once we've done that, click next. And once the process is complete, all we have to do now, I'll just take this folder, copy it, and paste it in the virtual machine. So once this process is complete, all I have to do is now enter in this folder in the virtual machine now, and open my trading platform from there. So this has been how to set up a free virtual private server on Microsoft using the Microsoft Azure cloud services. I also have a video illustrating how you can do the same with Microsoft with Amazon AWS. I'll leave a link in the description. So I hope this helps. If you like this kind of content, subscribe, and see you next time.